to explore, learn, and improve. Last week, we started the episode of Mr. Rowell Cruz about his journey as he became the Office Director of Culture and Arts at Don Honorio Ventura State University.
I am Rowell Cruz. I'm from Santa Rita, Pampanga. And I am a musician and a teacher by profession. And just recently, I was relegated as the Director of Culture and Arts, the Office of Culture and Arts here in Don Honorio Ventura State University. It was a roller coaster ride for me because even though I am a musician and I am known here in the university as a musician because of my background, my degree, it came to me biglaan lang. I was asked by my boss to be in the office. Nung una, hindi ko siya, nagulat ako eh. I was struck by the information that came to me. I am being, yun nga, relegated as an OIC director back then. In a span of 2 to 3 weeks, at first I was designated as the head of the museum, itong museum ng Heritage Museum ng University, and then after which I was designated as an OIC director for the Office of Culture and the Arts.
He also mentioned how they teach the students about the culture and arts of our country.
It's actually part of our Philippine Constitution because of Article 14. It talks about social justice. Being in the educational field, the educational institutions in the Philippines always have a hand in rearing our children, not only in the intellectual side, but also having them love their culture and their heritage, their tradition. And it's not just part of the program or the curriculum, but it's a thrust by the government. And being in a state university, malaki ang role na ginagawa ng culture and the arts sa development ng mga bata.
Mr. Rowell has gone through a lot too, just to reach his dreams.
When I graduated in high school, there's only one thing constant dun sa pag-iisip ko noon nung bago ko graduate ng fourth year pala. No? Gusto ko lang talagang makapasok sa UST because para sa akin, walang ibang university na pwede kong pasukan kung di yung UST. It's my dream school talaga. Bata pa lang ako, pinangarap ko na talaga makapasok ng UST. So sabi ko, ano kaya ang pwede kong dalhin sa UST para tanggapin nila ako? So wala akong kayang dalhin, sabi ko sa sarili ko that time, kung hindi yung boses ko, sabi ko. When I look back, nakita ko yung siguro kamay ng Diyos na gumabay sa akin. Kasi kung hindi ako pumasok ng konserbatoryo, hindi ko siguro nagawa at hindi ko nagagawa at hindi ko magagawa pa yung mga dapat kong gawin ngayon sa buhay ko na sa palagay ko at I firmly believe ito yung gustong ipagawa sa akin ng Diyos.
Now, he can share his talent with his students and choir members. He can also influence them through music with his skills in teaching.
When you are a musician, madali eh. Madali siya. It's very easy for you to influence other people. Just by singing, but just by performing, you can really reach out immediately. Instantaneously, naapektuhan mo na yung ibang tao. No? When I decided to enter the conservatory, I took up Bachelor of Music in Voice. And then I shifted to Bachelor of Music in Music Education. Yun yung first degree ko. The music field is not only performance kasi. Whether you like it or not, you will be a pedagogue. Someday, you will teach young children. You will pass on the knowledge. You will pass on the skills. Yun, pinili ko na maging teacher din. And yun nga, sabi ko kanina, it's very opportune din na nakapag-decide ako early on na parisan yung aking talento sa musika with the skill of teaching.
Today, we will hear more from the stories and tips of Mr. Rowell Cruz. So join us to explore, learn, and improve. Here in Sensei, there are skills and talents.
Thank you, sir. Search ko kayo sa Simba. Nakapag-day na din ko kayo ng how do you help those people who are serving the church, especially to acquire to play or to sing?
I always do this. Pag may performance ako or meron akong importanteng gawain, like for example, a workshop or a seminar or a performance lecture, I always ask my friends to pray for me, because I believe when they pray for me, they are not I'm not just asking for their favor, no, but I am returning the favor in sa kanila din, no, in return. Kasi parang naiisip ko, pag nagpapadasal ako sa kanila, nalalapit din sila sa Diyos. So I connect this always, no, kapag nagtuturo naman ako or when I ask people to join us in the ministry, baka gusto niyong kumanta. Kasi I believe that hindi naman talaga ako yung nag-i-invite kung hindi yung si God. Siya mismo, parang ginaguide niya lang or ginagamit niya lang tayo to become instruments, no? Para yung ibang tao mapalapit din sa kanya. Ngayon that I am working in the ministry, in the music ministry, nakita ko yung importance ng yung sinasabi nilang succession planning. Kasi nakita ko yun dun sa teacher ko eh.
You are still watching Sensei? For more Sensei Limang Siglo videos, you can visit our socials.
Kayo po as a choir master, paano niyo po tinuturuan or tinuturuan po yung mga choir members or yung choir niyo po to be a better server po sa simbahan?
Okay, as for my choir, syempre, malaking bagay din yung sabi ko kanina, yung patience at saka yung time, no? When I say I give my full patience to my choir, I understand that they are not musicians like me. So, malaking bagay yung acceptance that not all people can become like you or they are like you. Minsan, nahihirapan tayo minsan sa pagtuturo, no? Pero nakakatulong ako sa kanila siguro by giving them my patience, number one. Kasi when I give my patience to them, mas natututo sila. Mahirap maging pasensyoso, lalo na sa pagtuturo ng musika. Pero yun, number one yun, para makatulong ka bilang isang musician. Number two, again, yung time, no? Because I think more than any other gift, sabi nga nila, no? Isa sa mga regalong hindi mo mababayaran yung oras kasi. At I think yun yung pinakamalaki din na regalong pwede ko ding maibigay sa mga tinuturuan ko, yung mga choristers, yung mga choir na hinahandle ko. Kasi when I give them my time, natutulungan ko sila para ma-develop yung skills nila musically, and also it's like a form of catechism as well, because what I've learned from my mentors, from my teachers, from my former parish priests, from other spiritual guides like yung mga madre na nakakausap ko, yung mga na-attendan ko ng mga seminar sa liturgical music, na ituturo ko din sa kanila. It's a big form of catechism also for them. When we do rehearsals, it's not just purely the musical rehearsals, music rehearsals, but it's also a teaching of what music ministry or the ministry inside the church is.
How about you? What are the practices that you do to be a better choir master?
Ayan, malaking trabaho yan para sa akin. So, kasi yun nga, bago ka magturo, dapat may alam ka. You cannot give what you don't have. So, as musicians, makaka-relate yung mga karamihan ng mga conductor dyan, mga choir master, mga church musicians, that when you accompany a choir or when you teach a choir inside the church, you need to learn all their parts. So, if you're doing a four-part mix chorus, SATB, no? Soprano, alto, tenor, bass. Kailangan aralin mo yun lahat. So, it requires you a lot of patience also for yourself, no? And also, it requires you a lot of time. Ako, ang ginagawa ko is, malaking part ng preparation ko is picking out appropriate music for my choir. Not only liturgically, kung ano yung tama at appropriate na kantahin nila, pero yung appropriate din sa skill nila. Because hindi naman lahat advanced in singing at hindi naman lahat advanced sa maybe pagbabasa ng notes, note reading, or pagplay ng instruments. So I also have to adjust by picking out or choosing the correct music setting for them. And also, when I rehearse them, I also prepare like a lesson plan for them, no? Just like in teaching, for them to learn efficiently dun sa time na ibibigay sa amin. Kasi yung service natin sa church, hindi naman siya araw-araw makakapag-practice kayo. So I also plan for that. Pinaplano ko rin siya. Kasi malaking chunk din yung ng preparation is yung coordination with the choir and yung choir master. So yun yung mga sinasaalang-alang ko para mas mapagbuti ko yung aking duty or responsibility being a choir master.
Is there any advice that you can give to those people who are interested to be a choir master or to be part of a choir?
Siguro ang aking advice or yung maibabahagi ko sa kanila is kasi yung technical part, skill yan eh. Matututunan mo yan. Mapag-aaralan mo yan. Pero my advice is that we have to listen to the voice of God calling us to serve. Kasi ako yun lang yung isang bagay na nanalig talaga ako. Hindi dahil may nakukuha ako, pero ang paniniwala ko kasi it's a form of repentance also for me. It's a sacrifice for me. Kasi alam ko na dahil doon ko nararanasan yung awa ng Diyos at saka yung biyaya niya sa akin. I always go back to the mercy and the grace of God to sustain me in my duty or my responsibility. Kasi yun nga, ang sabi ko, yung musicality, yung skill, napag-aaralan siya. Pero yung awareness mo dun sa tawag sa'yo ng Diyos, yung tugon mo din doon sa tawag niya, yun yung mas pagtuunan natin siguro ng pansin. Kasi hindi lahat minsan nakakatugon. Kasi syempre na naniniwala din tayo na iba-iba rin naman tayo ng dinaranas sa buhay natin, no? Pero once you decide that you will answer God's call, malaking bagay siya to sustain everything that you want to do and everything that you want to give sa ministry mo, sa music ministry.
If there are people who are interested to learn more about music or to serve the Lord church.
Ayun po. So, kung meron man po kayong, sa palagay ninyo, may talento kayo sa pagkanta, sa pagtugtog ng instrumento, we have our parishes po all throughout the across the archdiocese. Lapitan nyo po yung mga ministers ninyo sa music, mga parish priest ninyo. Masaya pong mag-serve para sa simbahan at para sa Diyos. Kasi, by serving the Lord, you will encounter His mercy and it follows po na pati yung grasya ng Diyos, mararanasan nyo rin po siya. So, kung sa tingin nyo naman po ay hindi kayo masyadong marunong kumanta, i-approach nyo pa rin po sila, malay nyo, maturuan namin kayo at matulungan namin kayo para makita at ma-experience nyo din yung talento ninyo na hindi nyo pa nararanasan or nailalabas.
How about those people who are interested to learn about the culture and arts of the Philippines in our province? friends, please invite them po.
I would like to invite everyone to visit us here in Don Honorio Ventura State University Heritage Museum. This is the old building of the university, and of course, this is a part of the Office of Culture and the Arts of the university. Makikita niyo po dito yung history ng university. By visiting, we can talk to each other and then we can connect so that you will also know the programs and projects of the Office of the Culture and the Arts. And who knows, we might collaborate with you in the future and we'll have a great time knowing not only the heritage of the Kapampangan and the Filipinos, but also service, not only for the community, but for the nation and God. Yun po yung thrust ng university, ng Don Honorio Ventura State University. It's for God, for honor, and for men.
You are still watching Sensei? For more Sensei in Limang Siglo videos, you can visit our socials.
Can talk to each other and then we can connect so that you will also know the programs and projects of the Office of the Culture and the Arts. And who knows, we might collaborate with you in the future and we'll have a great time knowing not only the heritage of the Kapampangan and the Filipinos, but also service, not only for the community, but for the nation and God. Yun po yung thrust ng university, ng Don Honorio Ventura State University. It's for God, for honor, and for men.
Is there a university or terms that you think about to sum up the lessons or the things that you've learned from your experiences? What are those things?
I will go back again to patience, and then acceptance, and then gratitude. Kasi para sa akin, yung people have shown me patience all throughout my life. It's a gift that I have received and now I am giving. And also acceptance, because I think that when you are aware of your situation in life and then you fully accept it, it goes a lot better when you act on your decisions at saka yung mga ibang factor or facets ng life mo. Mas nagiging magaan when you have acceptance or when you exercise acceptance in your life. And gratitude, kasi yun nga, kapag ikaw ay nakatanggap at ikaw ay nakapagbibigay na rin, malaking parte ng buhay mo should always revolve around gratitude. Kasi alam mo na may mas malaki responsibilidad na nakaatang sa balikat mo, pero mas maraming grasya ang bumabalik dahil doon. And when you do things knowing that you're doing them not because of your own talent or your own doing, no, but knowing that God has given you everything that you need, that's why you are able to do things. Yung isang bagay lang na may ibibigay mo sa kanya is yun, gratitude at pagkilala na siya talaga ang Diyos mo at tagapagligtas mo.
As a musician po, sir, ano ba yung music niyo po ngayon sa buhay? Is there one specific song po na
naiisip? Marami kasi akong songs na gusto, no? Depende sa, siguro depende sa mood ko or ano. Pero I always go back to this one song. I think the original is sung by Mary Black. Pero ni-revive siya ng band, yung Irish band na The Corrs. It's entitled No Frontiers. So isang lyrics doon sa No Frontiers. It talks about humanity and it talks about the goodness in humanity and our struggles in life. Tapos may linya siya doon na sabi niya, "And I see heaven in your eyes." So there is this longing in us to find heaven wherever it is. Maybe here on earth, we can also find heaven. We can also see heaven in the eyes of our students, our family, mga kapatid natin, mga magulang natin, mga anak, mag-anak natin. even in the eyes of people we do not know. So we can see heaven. And I believe that the love of God has no frontiers. So yun, yun ang isang song na pwede kong ma-share.
Thank you for joining us in this episode featuring Mr. Roel Cruz. He is not just the Office Director of Culture and Arts at Don Honorio Ventura State University, but also an inspiring student, a great teacher, and a humble servant of the Lord. May he inspire us not to forget to use our talents to serve the Lord through sharing it with others. And a reminder that we all deserve to explore, learn, and improve because life is a continuous learning process. See you again next week. This is Sensei, Fair Skills and Talents.